Jeffrey Dahmer's crimes seem like a nightmare, but that doesn't mean he wasn't all too real. Who was he? Why did he do any of it? How did he not get caught? We're going to answer all the questions you're sure to have about the real monster after watching Dahmer. The details of his heinous crimes are extremely disturbing. Please watch with caution. Is monster based on a real person? Yes, Jeffrey Dahmer was a rapist and serial killer who haunted Milwaukee in the late 1980s and early 1990s. Prior to his arrest and confession in 1991, he killed and mutilated 17 men. The murders caused a nationwide media frenzy. When was Dahmer's first kill? Dahmer was surprisingly young when he first killed, just 18. That's much younger than your average serial killer at 27 and a half. However, there was an unusually long gap between his first and second murders, with the latter taking place when Dahmer was, in fact, 27. Did Dahmer wear yellow contacts, and if so, why? We know that Dahmer had a fascination with certain movies and movie characters. Exorcist 3 was one of his favorites. But he bought yellow contacts to more closely resemble Emperor Palpatine from Return of the Jedi. He later said that he related to a character of pure evil. Just how bad was the smell in Dahmer's apartment? The odor in the show was very real and very bad. It permeated the Oxford Apartments building, always pointing back to apartment 213. Pamela Bass stuffed towels beneath her door to block it, but it caused one tenant to just up and leave the building after a month. When neighbors chided Dahmer, he deflected, or once even bought Pine Sol, as if that would help. The sounds were nightmarish too. Buzzsaws, thumps, and crying. Did Dahmer have a vat of acid in his house? Yes. Dahmer had an industrial-grade 57-gallon barrel full of acid in his bedroom. When the police finally raided his apartment in 1991, they found multiple headless torsos in it, so now you understand the smell. According to a psychiatrist that spoke with him, Dahmer would wait until the bodies turned to slush, and then flush that down the toilet. Did Dahmer target black and brown people more frequently? He certainly seemed to, especially after moving to a predominantly black neighborhood. Out of his 17 confirmed victims, just 3 were white, and 2 of those didn't really fit his MO. 11 were African American, so you can understand why the black community in Milwaukee was upset, especially when it seemed for a while that Dahmer would be tried by an all-white jury. How badly did law enforcement mess up the Dahmer case? There are a few ways that law enforcement broke its own rules regarding Jeffrey Dahmer. The first is the infamous mishandling of the 14-year-old Laotian boy, Conorax Synthesimphom, who briefly escaped from Dahmer's apartment. A committee found that when the two officers returned the boy to Dahmer's clutches, despite neighbors' pleas, they violated 16 police rules, including failing to check Dahmer's records, which would have shown his prior sexual assault arrest. Adding insult to grave injury, the officers apparently made jokes over police radio after the incident. The second involves Dahmer's parole officer. Contrary to normal practice, she failed to visit Dahmer's apartment, either because of a heavy caseload or she didn't want to visit a high-crime neighborhood. Either way, though, Dahmer was allowed to use his killing den unimpeded. Did Infinity Land exist, and what were the rules? We know about Infinity Land through a childhood friend of Dahmer's who played it with him. It's a grim game that's even more shocking when you realize that it was designed by a 9-year-old Jeffrey. Players manipulated an army of stickmen, but if they got too close to each other, they were annihilated. Closeness was deadly. A spiral was placed over fallen figures, representing a black hole, oblivion. Did Dahmer really serve his neighbor a tainted sandwich? We don't know for sure, but we do know that Dahmer served a sandwich to his neighbor Pamela Bass on at least one occasion. Unlike the show's depiction, the relationship between Dahmer and Bass was a little less antagonistic. She even bought a couch off of him, so she actually ate the sandwich he offered. Understandably, she still wonders about its contents to this day. What did Dahmer's parents do? All things considered, they were fairly normal. Lionel Dahmer was a chemist at a giant paint and coating supplier, which probably and unfortunately caused his son's later fascination with and use of caustic chemicals. It's fair to say that Joyce Flint Dahmer struggled as a housewife during Dahmer's childhood, but by most accounts, she thrived in her second act as a case manager for AIDS patients in California. Both parents were apparently devastated by their son's crimes. What did Lionel really find in Grandma Dahmer's basement? In the show, Lionel finds a kind of chemical sludge, which seems damning enough. But what's really interesting is that Lionel's second wife, Sherry, suggested that he found more in media accounts after Dahmer's arrest. In 1991, she told a newspaper that Lionel didn't know if what he found were human bones or animal bones, but sounds like they were bones. Why did Dahmer get discharged from the army? We don't know why exactly, but we know he was honorably discharged in 1981 before his enlistment was up. Dahmer himself said that it was under Chapter 9 of the Code of Military Justice, which governs alcohol and drug use, but two soldiers, including his bunkmate, have since given horrific accounts that a drunken, violent Dahmer bullied, drugged, and raped them while in the service. Who was Anthony Hughes? Was he really deaf? Tony Hughes was a 31-year-old African-American man, Dahmer's 13th victim. He was indeed deaf and mute. There are reports that Hughes knew Dahmer for a few years, but he came home with Dahmer after meeting him at a Milwaukee gay club one night. His mom later recalled that he was friendly and energetic. Even after all Dahmer took from them, the Hughes family notably offered sympathy to Dahmer's parents after Dahmer's death. How many Polaroids did Dahmer have, and why? 74. The photos depicted bodies in various stages of dismemberment. They were like ghastly keepsakes. According to reports, even veteran cops were unable to look at them. What did Dahmer want to do with all these gruesome trophies? Dahmer planned to build a shrine or temple to Satan with his skulls and skeletons. This is actually his drawing. But he also used body parts for sexual gratification. Did Dahmer's victim really escape and go to the cops like that? Tracy Edwards is definitely real, but he isn't alone. At least five potential Dahmer victims escaped and later told friends, but Tracy was different. When Dahmer handcuffed and threatened him, and then flaunted his collection of mutilated bodies, Tracy used his knowledge of karate to free himself and tell the police. In articles around the time, he modestly refused to be called a hero, but Dahmer himself later said he would never have been caught without Tracy. Did the judge really give Dahmer such a lenient sentence? Unbelievably, yes. A state judge who presided over Dahmer's 1989 sexual assault case could have given him two consecutive sentences of 10 years. Instead, apparently moved by Dahmer's pleas for mercy, he gave him a year in prison with work release, plus probation and counseling, for sexually assaulting a teenage boy. It likely contributed to the loss of 12 lives. Was there a side of Dahmer we didn't see? Dahmer could be sly and manipulative when he wanted to be. There's an unbelievable story about how he went to DC on a high school trip and somehow talked his way into a private tour of Vice President Walter Mondale's office while the VP was there. And on the other side, we see a lot of his violent outbursts in the show, but he could also be relatively cautious. He typically didn't target men who had cars, for instance, fearing that the cars could be traced. Did Dahmer kill anyone else? Dahmer confessed at length to detectives, but serial killers are known to give partial confessions, leading some to believe that Dahmer may have killed more. On the very plausible side, there's Dean Vaughn, the real neighbor from episode 7 who was found raped and strangled one floor above Dahmer, but for whatever reason, cops never linked it to Dahmer. Perhaps more of a stretch is Adam Walsh, the infamously murdered son of America's Most Wanted host, John Walsh. Not only was Dahmer mere miles away at the time of Walsh's disappearance, but two witnesses claimed they saw a thin, blonde, disheveled man who they later ID'd as Dahmer in the toy store Walsh vanished from. What happened to the locations at which Dahmer killed? Dahmer killed at four locations, three in the Milwaukee area. His childhood home in Bath, Ohio, where he killed hitchhiker Stephen Hicks, still exists. In 2014, the three-bedroom was put on the market for about $300,000. The Ambassador Hotel in Milwaukee, where Dahmer blacked out and killed Stephen Toomey, is apparently much nicer than it was in the seedy early 90s. Rooms start now at $105 a night. Site of three killings, Dahmer's grandmother's two-story house also still exists on a quiet suburban street outside Milwaukee. There's no sales data we could find. Then there were the Oxford apartments. Dahmer committed so many crimes there that the Red Cross took the unusual step of designating its occupants as disaster victims. The building was torn down in the fall of 1992, although that wasn't without controversy for many of the poorer residents. Park or memorial was planned, but it never came to pass, so now it's just a barren lot. What happened to the man who killed Dahmer? Christopher Scarver pleaded no contest to the killing of Jeffrey Dahmer and one other inmate, and was sentenced to two consecutive life sentences on top of his first life sentence for burglary homicide. But initially, Scarver pleaded innocent by reason of insanity. He said voices of a family drove him to commit all of his murders, although he later admitted that Dahmer's alleged grotesque humor in the cafeteria influenced his decision. Those are just some of the most searched questions about Dahmer, but we'll probably never be able to answer everything about this incomprehensible monster.